everyone, this is Aimée. Welcome to my channel. Putting the time into developing the criteria for the program components is one of the best investments you can make as a skater. It really doesn't matter how high you can jump if you can't land on the right edge. Hold your landing and skate to the next element in a skilled and beautiful way. In my last video on IJS components, I discussed skating skills because I would argue, and I have, skating skills are the single most critical aspect of figure skating. Aside from skating skills, four other components make up the IJS component score. The performance component appears to win more Olympic gold medals than any other component. In this video, we're gonna focus solely on performance. Think of this in terms of delivery, or the degree to which you deliver a successful performance, demonstrating a command of the overall program. This is the life of the composition. Performance is the involvement of the skater, pair, couple, physically, emotionally, and intellectually, as they deliver the intent of their music and composition. Performance should demonstrate the quality of movement and precision of delivery. Keep in mind that all motion requires energy. The proper amount of energy produces quality movement. Energy can be sustained and lyrical, or it can be aggressive. It can also dissipate if you lack stamina. Uncontrolled energy causes tension for you as a skater, as well as the audience, compromising the aesthetics and delivery of the program. IJS demands a rigorous understanding of requirements and criteria for component marking. Competitive figure skating programs must allow for the execution of elements while performing a composition for the best overall results. Component marks are a critical part of that score. If we're just meeting, my name is Aimée Ricca, and I'm a PSA ranked and rated figure skating coach. I'm also an ISSA certified elite trainer, certified specialist in strength and conditioning, and youth fitness specialist, as well as a precision nutrition PN1 certified nutrition coach. I work with skaters and their families to help them create change and get real results. Okay, so the IJS program component score, or PCS. If you're unfamiliar with IJS, it was developed as a collaborative global effort to produce a scoring system for figure skating that provides a precise, transparent evaluation of both the technical and artistic aspects of a competitive program. The marks are divided into two basic categories: the technical element score for the feats of athleticism, and the program component score, reflecting five different artistic aspects of the program. These two categories are independent of each other. Additionally, grade of execution, or GOE, will generally vary from element to element, and component scores will differ from one component to the next. Keep in mind that all scoring is relative to the actual performance in the moment of competition. Scores for the same program by the same skater may differ considerably from one competition to another. The goal of a skating performance is seamless and meaningful movement with properly integrated and successful fulfillment of required elements. These elements form the vital backbone of the skater's program. Programs as a whole cannot be thoroughly evaluated without applying the five components. In each segment of an event, the judges award five separate program component scores. The judges award points on a scale from 0.25 to 10, with increments of 0.25 for each program component to express the overall presentation and artistic mastery, of which 1 is very poor, 2 is poor, 3 is weak, 4 is fair, 5 is average, 6 above average, 7 is good, 8 is very good, 9 is excellent, and 10 is outstanding. There are 5 program components scored in the short program, short dance, and the free skate, free dance. Skating skills, transitions, performance, composition, interpretation of the music, timing for ice dance. Judges evaluate each program component. Together, the scores of the five components will be used in a formula to make up the program component score, PCS. The PCS is calculated and factored by specified percentages. All five program component marks are factored equally and then added together. It is this factored sum that constitutes the PCS. The idea behind factoring is to make the program components equal in score to the weight of the technical element score. The TES combines the grades of execution for each element plus a numerical degree of difficulty assigned in the scale of values. Since the perfect non-factored program component score is always 50, this number is factored to roughly equal each discipline's score in the TES, totaling the competition score, technical element score, TES, plus program component score, PCS, equals total segment score, TSS. This is a complicated formula, and I could spend hours explaining it. I'm sure you really don't want to hear me talk for hours. So you can find the tables for factors of components on the US Figure Skating website, usfigureskating.org. At the end of the competition, the skater is given a scoring sheet we call a protocol, detailing the evaluation result of each aspect of the program. This protocol provides all the details of the technical elements, as well as each of the program components. Errors, falls, and disruptions must be reflected in the marks. So, what are the criteria that judges use for evaluating performance? Performance is understanding the music and the message, and physically responding with movement that communicates the emotional connection to the audience. You must demonstrate a physical commitment that is also emotionally sincere and intellectually understood. Combine physical, emotional, and intellectual involvement allows you to demonstrate a spirit and vitality to your performance. The total commitment of your performance becomes a sensory and intellectual experience for the judges and the audience. Projection is the extra lift of the program and a feeling of totality and fulfillment of movement. Outward projection is when movement is initiated from your core and extends outward. A personal or inwardly directed performance uses movement pulled towards the body core. The spirit of performance is transferred from you to the judges and the audience. Energy and commitment enable you to interact with them. You'll establish a rapport with the judges as well as the audience. Your body's core alignment and posture should be trained to change fluid movement throughout your program. Give a full complement of energy to your every movement and well practice your movements with that full complement of energy so they can be executed with accuracy and clarity. Your performance should include a variety of movement, shapes, angles, and levels, along with a use of variety. Contrast to your program design provides depth, interest, and involvement. But you should always present variety and contrast in meaningful movement. Individuality is a unique crafted method of delivering artistic composition. You should demonstrate a unique and memorable sensitivity to time, space, and energy throughout your movement. Your collective qualities result in individual style and personality. In pairs and synchro, each skater must contribute equally to the overall performance. Visual unison should be apparent throughout the movements and elements of the program. There must be a balance of position and spacing, resulting in an appearance of oneness. Irregular or uncontrolled spacing breaks the overall unity. The judges and audience should be at ease as skaters move through positions without unplanned tension or stress. There should be a total awareness of the other skaters at all times. Some questions to ask yourself. Were you successful in executing the program, or were there many errors and disruptions? Were you committed with heart, body, and mind? Could the judges and audience feel your energy and the performance? And if you're in a pair, ice dance, or synchro, did you perform as a unit? Was there a natural awareness of the other skaters during the performance? Keep these points in mind as you practice and prepare for competition. Performance requires a quality of delivery and precision throughout the overall program. Your successful performance transcends the ice through spirited energy and commitment. Your performance should produce chemistry between you and the judges, as well as the audience. You must have adequate time and experience while developing a program to have the confidence to skate the program with an ease of performance and the ability to maximize flow and edges. So don't put together a program and try to compete it before you've even had enough time to practice. I've done that and it doesn't go well at all. Remember, there are several criteria to be considered before a judge assesses a component score. And each judge will often come to this score by different paths, in that each performance being evaluated is unique. Remember, judges assess and weigh the overall criteria for each component before awarding its mark. It's pretty common to have one or more component marks significantly different. For example, skating skills could be 5.5, while performance could be 3.75. Movement and how it occurs are critical to every component. Posing without movement takes away the essential athletic quality of glide and flow of the sport. Repetitive movement, or movement that frequently disconnects from the music, can become boring to the judges and the audience. Your music should drive continuous movement, and each component and criteria will provide you with artistic skills and understanding that will enrich all aspects of your skating. So make sure that you have a good primary coach that is PSA ranked and rated and focuses on the quality of your performance and all the components. Also, I've developed some worksheets that can really help you out here, and they're completely free. Just go to skatewithaimee.com/freebies and download the component checklist. These worksheets will give you an edge in competition. And if you missed my video about skating skills as a component, there's a link to it in the description down below. Definitely watch that. In future videos, I'm gonna go over other components: interpretation, composition, and transitions. So remember to subscribe and ring that bell so that you never miss a video. If you like this video, please hit the like button. And if you think someone else could benefit from it, share it with them and just post it to your social media too. This is Aimée. Happy skating. Thank you for watching. I will see you real soon. Bye.